Hey, what's up guys? In this video, I want to talk about be a gray man or be a gray woman. And what I mean by that is as responsible armed citizens that carry concealed, like a firearm, I feel that we should focus on blending in with the population, with society. Meaning, I did a video a couple years ago called Tactical Vest Equals I'm Carrying a Gun or Gun Fishing. And, back in the day, year 2000, when I worked for the armored car company, sometimes we would wear plain clothes. And at that time, they asked us to buy these Royal Robin pants and vest. Okay, and I did. I bought a bunch of them. And Royal Robins is now known as 5-Eleven. I think they sold the patents of the clothing to a company called 5-Eleven. We all know what 5-Eleven is. And that's those kind of clothes, even wearing that stuff out and about, you're kind of like, I don't want to say a target, but you're definitely like, hey, what's up with this guy? What's up with this dress? Because I can't tell you how many times I've been made by cops and responsible armed citizens alike, and just the average Jane Joe that would ask me, well, what's up with your clothing? Back in those times, back in 2005, I remember I was wearing that kind of stuff still, because that was a time where I was trying my hand at IDPA, going to matches. And I would wear a tactical vest for those matches. And sometimes I'd just go out and about and wear that kind of clothing at the mall, at the movie theater, at the grocery store, just going to a restaurant. And you stand out. You look kind of strange. Some people will actually laugh at you and be like, what's up with this guy? He looks like he's going on a safari. Okay, I've had cops ask me, hey, what are you carrying? It's like out of the blue, out of Dunkin' Donuts, like, what are you carrying? Or sometimes some other responsible armed citizens will be like, hey, where's the match? You're going to IDPA match? Where's the range? Or the average Jane Joe will just ask, hey, where are you going fishing? Where are you going to catch some fish and stuff like that? So that kind of dress stands out. 5-Eleven, Blackhawk. Depending on what you're wearing, it just stands out. Now, recently, fast forward to 2015, I was at a mall and I saw this guy with a huge beard wearing a 5-Eleven vest and some type of tactical pants that had a lot of pockets and stuff. And I could see his, a blade clipped to his pocket and stuff like that. And the way he was walking, he had a gun on his hip. Definitely. He was kind of checking it, patting it down. His gait, okay, when he was walking was off. Because he had something on his strong side hip. All these tells, I could tell the guy's got a gun on him. Hopefully he was a good guy. Most likely he was. What feral being or scumbag lowlife or criminal is going to wear a tactical vest and tactical pants and go out like that? Probably not, unless, some will. Okay, like the ones that aren't all there. They might dress up like a commando, but other than that, most likely it's someone that it's on our side. But they stand out. That's the point. They just stand out so much. When I see someone wearing a photographer's vest, I'm kind of thinking to myself, my radar's up. I know the guy's probably carrying a gun. I don't know if he's a good guy or a bad guy. Hopefully he's a good guy. And I kind of just keep my eye on that person. It's just natural because they're dressed like that. So I guess the point of this video is we got to blend in. And I'm showing you these pants right here because, there was a company called EOTAC. I think that's what they were called. I used to have a bunch of pants by them, a shirt, and a jacket made by them. And they were kind of okay. Their jacket was a little funny because if I had to describe it, because I don't own any of the stuff anymore. I sold it all on eBay. The EOTAC jacket had like a zipper that zipped just up front. So it would leave the bottom part kind of free so you could access your firearm on strong side hip. And some people would ask me, is your jacket broken? Like they'd be like, what's up with their jacket? Why doesn't it zip up from the bottom? Like what the hell's wrong with that thing? So I got a lot of feedback from people that I knew to strangers that thought the thing looked ugly, it looked kind of strange, what's wrong with you? You look weird wearing that. So I sold it on eBay. Their pants were not too bad. They had hidden pockets and stuff like that, but unfortunately they didn't fit me when I got them and I couldn't return them, so I sold them on eBay. But their pants weren't bad. And the button-up shirt was just kind of weird looking and just looked kind of like a uniform. So I got rid of them, sold them on eBay. I don't know if that company is still around. I think they're called EOTAC. I can't find anything about them anymore, so it looks like they went out of business. So that company was okay. I wear a vest still, but it's made by Kakadu. Okay, and it's not conspicuous. I've gotten a lot of compliments on this vest, and I still wear it out. I will never wear a photographer's or, you know, 5'11 type tactical vest out and about anymore. It just doesn't make sense. So if you're looking for a vest, I highly suggest you just go to one of the trendy stores out there, like The Gap or, you know, whatever. One of those trendy stores, you'll be able to find something, because we should blend in with the population, because we're in such a sensitive environment. We don't know if the, you know, the mother that's anti-gun will just say, oh my God, you know, I don't know. You know, I don't, you guys know what I'm trying to get at. But I think that we should go to the trendy stores to look for something that would help conceal the firearm that we're going to carry out in public. In that sense, we're going to blend in with the crowd. There are a lot of nice vests out there that will work, you know, work out. But I wanted to show you these pants right here, because I think these Carhartt pants are a good example. I've actually gotten 4 pairs of these, because they were on sale for like $28, and they're normally pretty expensive, $52, but they were only $28, so I bought 4 pairs, 4 different colors. And I like these pants because they're not as conspicuous. The belt looping are spaced just right to be able to, you know, use a holster in whatever position you'd like. They don't have like a ton of pockets per se. The reason why I really like this, I know this is going to sound funny, they have this nice side pocket here that fits perfect for my iPhone 6 Plus. It goes right in there perfectly. And rather than putting this in a front pocket, I put it right in the side pocket. I've actually had people come up to me at the mall and say, hey, that's really cool. That's a nice, like, you know, holster that's, you know, sewn right into the pants. What kind of pants are those? So I had a few people ask me about that because of the iPhone 6 Plus being able to fit right in there. It's pretty cool. But anyways, it has these large front pockets here. So just a note, if you do pocket carries such as a LCR or a J-frame, these pockets for these type of Carhartt pants are huge. So be aware of that, because if you use a pocket holster, most likely it's just going to fall in here. And if you had to draw, you're going to pull your J-frame or LCR out with the holster on there, and you'll have to go to immediate drill by punching it out, getting that holster off, and then going to work. But I just want to let you know that these pockets are huge, so a pocket holster may not work very well with these Carhartt pants. But I like these pants because they're not conspicuous. They have this side pocket here for my iPhone 6 Plus. The belt loops, that's the most important thing, are spaced correctly so I can get a holster where I want it and tighten it down. Now, I'm carrying a revolver, so my speed loaders, I carry 2 8-shot loaders, are most likely right now, since it's, you know, temperatures are still low, in a jacket pocket. All right, so having speed loaders put in the front pocket here, it's kind of iffy. But when the summertime comes, if I am still carrying a revolver, I'll utilize cargo shorts. And there's a lot of pockets there, you know, on those. And they're not as conspicuous, cargo shorts. And but for something like this, it just has 2 front large pockets. This utility pocket right here on your strong side, I guess if you want to call it, or my strong side, that can carry an iPhone 6 Plus. But if you don't have one, you can put something else in here. But this is a great pocket for the smartphone nowadays. It can go right in there. Or an iPhone. But it does have another pocket on this side, you know, that you could put a magazine in, all right? And it fits just right for a mag. So that's just something I want to show you guys, because rather than have a magazine on the, you know, side here, you can have it right here. Or you can have both. A pouch here, and you can put another spare here. 2 mags. Up to you. I can't put a speed loader in here because it drops all the way down here, and if something were to go down, I had to reload my revolver immediately, I could fumble and I could have a problem trying to get it out. So I just wanted to show you these pants made by Carhartt, and I think they're really cool. And I think they work out very well, and it blends in with the population. A lot of people wear Carhartt. Or if you don't like this style of pant, there's many other ones that are, I guess you want to call them trendy, that will work out for you most likely. For these, since I carry a friggin' N-frame inside the waistband, I buy them 2 sizes up, so that's something you gotta realize. If you're gonna carry inside the waistband, you gotta buy 2 sizes up. So, let's pretend your size 34, you go with a 36 to accommodate that. Now that's going to be pretty important. But guys, let me know what you think. Let's share what kind of clothing are you utilizing for concealed carry. Like, name some brands, I guess, or maybe some of the stores you may go to, because people ask me, they really do, like, hey, I don't want to buy Black Hawk. You know, I don't want to buy 511. You know, I don't want to buy, you know, this and that, because they look too tactical. I want to blend in with the population. Can you suggest anything? Some people suggest good old Wally World has some jeans, I guess, apparently, that are inexpensive, and they work very well for concealed carry. I don't know what that is. I think it's called Faded Glory. But I suggest Carhartt. Look at their kind of stuff, because you'll blend in fine. And these pants specifically, canvas work dungaree, are low-key and enough pockets for me. And the, like I said, the belt loops are spaced just right for a holster. And it has this great pocket right here for my iPhone 6 Plus. And like I said, if you want to, most people are going to be carrying a semi-auto. They have a nice little pocket on this side where you can drop a magazine in there, if you so desire. So, but other people, you know, they're asking me what stores, you know, what type of pants that are trendy per se, or what kind of vests that are trendy per se. So if you guys could help us all out, leave some, I don't know, model numbers of certain type of clothing that works for you, that's very low key, that'll be cool. All right, that's about it, guys. So as always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.